Hello everyone, I'm Jason Mays, Developer Relations Engineer for TensorFlow.js here at Google, and today we'll be covering what's new in TensorFlow.js for 2022. Now, if you're new to WebML, TensorFlow.js is Google's machine learning library for JavaScript, and it's just like the original version of TensorFlow that came out in Python, but is aimed at folk who code in JavaScript or Node.js instead. This allows more developers to use machine learning without having to learn a new language and use their creations in even more places than ever before, as JavaScript can run pretty much anywhere. From client-side to server-side, mobile-native to desktop-native, and even IoT devices like a Raspberry Pi, JavaScript is one of the few languages that can run in all of these locations without any additional dependencies. And currently, over 68% of professional developers use JavaScript in production. All of these users can potentially benefit from adding machine learning models to their web application. And what are those benefits? Well, by running in the browser, you can achieve privacy, as no sensor data needs to be sent to the cloud for inference. Or how about lower latency for real-time performance with direct access to the device? And of course, lower costs, as fewer server-side resources need to be kept running. You also get zero install for a frictionless user experience, and you can use any of our demos in just one click of a link, and reach your audience of billions instantly, with no complex environment setup, in a way people can share with ease. And if you're new to machine learning, we're pleased to announce that we've just launched a brand new course for web and creative folk who are new to this industry but familiar with web technologies. Here you can go from zero to hero in machine learning in JavaScript and bring your creative ideas to life with TensorFlow.js. This course will teach you how to use machine learning in the browser to create next generation web apps with superpowers from object recognition to text understanding and much more. Enroll today for free using the link on this slide and go at your own pace. Furthermore, following many requests from the community, we're pleased to announce the launch of the Coral Edge TPU support in Node.js via a special build of a library called tfjs-tfite-node. This will allow JavaScript developers to load and use any tf-lite model and execute it on a connected TPU Edge device within the Node.js ecosystem. So if you own a Raspberry Pi and you're looking to do low-latency model inference on such a device, you now can, and keep all your code in JavaScript without needing to learn a new language. Check the CodeLab link to learn how to use this feature. Now, on the subject of learning about TensorFlow.js, let's check a few examples of how people are using this knowledge with projects made by our global community.
I use 3JS, which is a JavaScript library, which allows you to visualize a 3D object, attract the face of the user with a pre-trained face tracking model in TensorFlow.js. It moves as I move, so it works left or right or up and down.
That really pops out of the screen. That's amazing. It's so realistic.
What we created was a sports platform that helped teams, amateur teams such as myself, to access sports performance data and statistics easily and affordably. So we created a platform that enables both coaches and players to use artificial intelligence and TensorFlow models to generate the performance statistics they need to understand why are they winning games or not winning games, and how can they improve their performance, whether it's from a conditioning or from a skills perspective. And that is, in a nutshell, is team sports.
What you're seeing is a very short looping video clip of a martial artist doing his routine. And what I'm doing is using PoseNet to extract the pose of the different body parts and extruding it in both time and space in augmented reality.
That's super cool.
The 3D form / visualization.
This project was made as a sort of demonstrator project to show how can we make autoencoders, how can we use them in TensorFlow.js. We're sampling not digits, the MNIST data, but a different data set, the Celeb A data set, which is a really great data set of celebrity faces.
We try to see how could we make a website that you could just interact with just your hands. So you need to do like a drag gesture to move things around, and you need to do like hover your hand over an object to kind of select it. And then spread your fingers to click it.
So TensorFlow.js, I realized that all the building blocks were in place now, and I could actually build an end-to-end system that would solve Sudoku puzzles in your browser. And you can see it's scanning the puzzle and solving it as we scan over the images in the newspaper.
So a couple of months ago, we open sourced this project called Pose Animator that allow you to use your body to animate your SVG characters. SVG, as it is, still requires quite a bit of design expertise to create, but we want to lower the bar even further so that anyone can create a character and animate them.
Recently, I've been exploring using TensorFlow.js with imagery. If you think about looking at a map and you see the, it's almost like a photo draped across the world. So that's satellite imagery. So we've been looking at using satellite as well as drone and UAV imagery to recognize objects. And fundamentally, if we look at the TensorFlow.js sample website, you know, we've got the webcam sample where you can show an object and it can show back what that is. You can do the same techniques with imagery in GIS.
Okay. As you can probably tell, I'm a huge fan of VTubers, which is why I'm currently in this form. I've been working on a lot of VTuber web apps that allow you to do real-time motion capture directly in the browser.
I was thinking, okay, and could we do this in JavaScript using TensorFlow.js? And
here it is.
Here it is. It works. Yep. In the terminal, we start the driving script, which uses the model we have built to drive a car. And you can see it drives. It knows only two commands. The positive value is turn right, and the negative value is turn left. And the car drives pretty well.
Wow, some amazing projects there by our community, and many of these leverage our pre-made models that you can use in just a few lines of code, even if you've got no background in machine learning. And on this slide, you can see all the models we released, with several new updates for 2022 highlighted in bold that I'll walk you through shortly. You can use our models across many areas like vision, body understanding, text, and sound in just a few lines of JavaScript code. Check out tensorflow.org/js/models to see them all as we add even more over time. Okay, so what model updates are new for 2022? Well, first up, we're pleased to announce the launch of a brand new selfie depth estimation model that's capable of estimating the distance from each pixel to the camera as illustrated by the images on this slide. Now, if you can understand the depth of the human body in an image, you can do some amazing things. For example, enabling 3D photos live in the browser. Here, a single image is passed through the selfie depth estimation model, allowing the user to produce a subtle 3D effect that can bring the image to life. Or how about image relighting, as shown in this demo? Here, the user is able to use 3.js, a 3D graphics library, along with some custom shaders, to cast light rays around the person in the scene, as the depth information is now known for the person's body. Next, we also launched a 3D pose estimation model in collaboration with MediaPipe, a research team here at Google, that can estimate 33 key points on a human body in real time. This model has three forms, a light, full, and heavy version, which allows you to select a trade-off between accuracy or speed. The light model, for example, can run at 150 frames per second on a modern desktop computer. And already, we've seen the VTuber community embrace this new 3D pose estimation model to drive virtual avatars that can be used to join live streams or digital meetings in a real-time manner using nothing more than a regular webcam, and can work on any device with a web browser. Really impressive work, and we look forward to seeing what you create with these new models too. Continuing our MediaPipe collaboration, we've also released a brand new body segmentation model. Here you can now retrieve a segmentation mask showing which pixels belong to a human body versus those that do not, as shown in the animation. Even better, as this expands upon the pose estimation model you just saw, it's able to do this with minimal additional overhead. In fact, this model is now part of our unified pose API linked on the slide if you need both pose and body segmentation returned at the same time. Furthermore, it's both faster and more accurate than our previous BodyPix model you might have tried before. And on a modern desktop, the lighter segmentation model can run over 120 frames per second. Now, related to this, there's also a version of this model that's optimized for selfie segmentation, allowing you to create effects like the one shown here, where you can change the background in a video conferencing app for privacy. In fact, this model is a modified version of the one we use on Google Meet for video conferencing here at Google. Now, this version of the model is better suited for close-ups as shown, where the user is less than 2 meters from the camera. It can run over 200 frames per second on a modern desktop computer and is available via a unified segmentation API on the link shown. Next, let's turn our focus to our hands. Updates to the hand pose model now enable tracking of multiple hands simultaneously in 3D and 2D with a higher precision than before when trying to estimate more extreme angles. On a modern desktop computer, it can run over 120 frames per second. This new model could be used to help enable gesture recognition for applications like sign language interpretation or even novel human-computer interaction opportunities. So what will you make? It's time to get creative. Moving to the face, we're also updating our face landmark detection API that builds upon the existing face mesh model you may have already tried. This new API has even higher accuracy and detail for face landmark movements and is based on the latest MediaPipe model that was developed in alignment with Google's AI principles. As you can see from the demo shown, it can run over 130 frames per second in the desktop browser on a modern computer. Try it out for yourself on the link shown, and furthermore, this API now supports a lightweight option that just returns bounding boxes and 6 key points of a face for faster performance on less powerful devices. Now in TensorFlow.js, you can run existing pre-made models like you just saw, leverage TensorFlow to create new custom models for your own use cases, or write models completely from scratch, all in JavaScript. And it should also be noted that TensorFlow.js is now able to support the execution of other forms of TensorFlow models, either directly or through a command line converter, giving JavaScript developers a whole suite of options for using machine learning in their web apps. Currently, we can digest and run TensorFlow Lite, MediaPipe, TensorFlow Hub, and even TensorFlow Python models after conversion with our command line tool, which can help you get even more eyes on your research with an audience far larger than before, as the web is designed to have high shareability with a single link. And on that note, our benchmarking tooling has been upgraded to also support TF-Lite models directly in the browser. Here, you can simply reference any TF-Lite model as shown and get key performance metrics returned to help you understand the performance on any device you wish to run it on, allowing you to select the best model to deploy in production with confidence. Which brings us on to backends. TensorFlow.js supports multiple backends that you can choose to execute on. Now note that by backend here, I do not mean server-side. This is a special term indicating what client-side hardware the machine learning model will run on. On the left, you've got the CPU, which is always available, essentially vanilla JavaScript, but it's the slowest form of execution running on the computer's processor. Now, you also have WebAssembly for faster CPU execution, which for smaller models can even match client-side graphics card performance due to advances for this web API. You then have WebGL that can leverage the graphics card, or GPU if you will, which supports 97.6% of devices out there, greatly expanding the range of devices you can perform machine learning on in a very fast manner. Now, focusing on the WebGL backend, in 2021, we observed that some users who are using larger models here noticed a user interface block whilst initializing the model on the GPU. Due to the size of such models, the first load and initialization can take several seconds to complete, and would use 100% of the GPU resources available, which a browser also uses to repaint the web page. We're pleased to announce that TensorFlow.js now implements a solution to this, enabling jank-free web apps when loading larger machine learning models, as shown in the animation on this slide. In the top image, the interface is blocked from repainting itself, but in the updated version below, the information is rendered instantly. Just be sure to be using the latest version of the TensorFlow.js library to get this update for free. We've also launched a new API function in our 3.13.0 release to extend the ways you can return data from a tensor to enable more efficient GPU-based pipelines. You can now simply call tensor.data2GPU to keep the data in the graphics card memory as a texture, enabling a huge performance boost if you're able to keep all your post-processing on the graphics card too, without needing to inspect the raw data in JavaScript on the CPU. This works just like existing tensor data sync functions you might be used to in TensorFlow.js, but is particularly important when dealing with dense data coming back from, for example, segmentation models where pixel-level data is returned. In those cases, that data transfer to the CPU can take a non-trivial amount of time due to its size. In the demo shown here, syncing segmentation data to the CPU to inspect and then rendering to Canvas 2D results in 15 frames per second. But if you keep the data on the GPU with this new function and render that texture directly to Canvas 3D, you can get over 90 frames per second instead. Check the link for more information. And finally, looking towards the future, we're seeing new web standards being formed, namely WebNN and WebGPU, which we're also investigating to accelerate performance even further. And today, we're pleased to announce that the TensorFlow.js WebGPU backend is now available in alpha form. And here you can see just a few models we've tested on the new WebGPU alpha backend. Many existing models will get a boost by running on WebGPU, like our body pick segmentation model, which previously took 44.6 milliseconds to run on WebGL, but now takes just 21.7 milliseconds to run on WebGPU on the same machine. We encourage you to try your models on this new backend to see how they might perform on WebGPU in the future when it's more generally available and enabled by default on modern web browsers. For now, you will need to enable a browser flag to try this alpha feature out. More details are provided on the link shown. And with that, I'd like to leave you with a few resources you can use to get started or go further with TensorFlow.js. First up, check out our growing collection of code labs at codelabs.developers.google.com. You can simply search TensorFlow.js on this site to find a whole bunch of useful step-by-step guides as they come out from the TensorFlow.js team here at Google. And if there's one side you want to screenshot, here are some links that you might want to bookmark. First, you can find our official website for more details on the library itself, and of course a full API on the link at the top of this slide. Or check out even more of our pre-made models as they come out using the second link. You can view our open source code on GitHub and even make a contribution if you're up for the challenge. We are fully open source after all. Next, check out the official TensorFlow forum, which is a great place to ask more technical questions and is monitored by the TensorFlow.js team. Just remember to tag your post with tfjs so we can find it. Now, we've also got code examples for you to use and can fork in minutes over on glitch.com and copen.io that provide working boilerplate code to get started really fast. Naturally, these examples will continue to grow over time, so do check them out. And if you're looking for inspiration, head on over to our short 10-minute interviews on YouTube via our Made with TensorFlow.js series. Here, I interview people who have made great things using machine learning and JavaScript on the official TensorFlow YouTube channel, which may just give you some ideas for your next project or find some interesting folk to connect with from the community. Either way, it's a great way to fill a coffee break with these bite-sized videos or share to others who might be interested to learn more about what's going on with machine learning in JavaScript. Now, the only thing left to say at this point is, what will you make? Come join our growing community. Machine learning really now is for everyone. Creatives, artists, musicians, no matter what your background, and I hope TensorFlow.js can enable more people than ever before to start their journey with machine learning. There are too many examples coming out every single month to fit in a single presentation, so check out the hashtag MadeWithTFJS on social, such as Twitter and LinkedIn, to see what people are making around the world. And if you make something using TensorFlow.js, be sure to use the tag for a chance to be featured at our future events, and I really look forward to seeing what you create. And with that, thanks for watching. You can connect with me directly if you've got any questions around WebML or TensorFlow.js using the social links on the left. And of course, if you're wanting to further your knowledge, check out the links on the right and take our brand new course that will take you from zero to hero with machine learning in JavaScript. That's all from me, and I'll see you next time.